on this most holy night when we come together to remember, to celebrate, to know that something happens that literally changes the world. And we all get to be a part of that one more time here tonight. Because the reality is, we have to be reminded over and over again about Emmanuel, God with us. Somehow we just start letting go of that, not thinking about it in the way that we should. And so I start our time together with these words from Bishop Stephen Carlston. Please join me today, whoever you are, whatever you believe. Join me in releasing love into the world. Love as mercy, love as peace, love as forgiveness, love as healing. Join me in sharing love in every way you can. And when you do, join me in believing it will make a difference. Love always makes a difference. Please join me today in extending that love as far as your heart can reach. I invite you to stand as you are able and let us sing our welcoming song, The First Noel, verses 1 and 2. Up and standing, you can turn and greet your neighbors and say Merry Christmas to all.
Thank you.
I invite you to respond with movement as you are moving yourself into worship. Showing up was a big act, but now would you, as you are able, be willing to stand as we proclaim these words of coming into worship together. We gather today. We listen for God.
It is time to hear.
It is time to hear and to be loved. It is time to be loved. It is time to serve others. Let us continue our worship together by singing, O Come All Ye Faithful, verses 1 and 4. May be seated. All of this Advent season, we have been using the theme of time, and we continue that theme tonight. And after we light the Advent wreath, we say these words, and then we will sing the song Out of Time that will be on the screen. We've learned about time as that time that we anticipate, that time that we look forward to, that it begins to get smaller and shorter, and then we are out of time. There is no time. And this is the place that we find ourselves, understanding what no time means.
And Mary gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place in the guest room.
Let us pray. Emmanuel, God with us, the time is now. You are here. We light every candle on our wreath because your presence glows among us. However this night finds us, filled with joy or touched by grief, alone or in the company of our loved ones, you are with us and you will never leave. And so we sing with the angels, Alleluia and Amen.
No time. We have no time left. Or maybe what we have left is beyond the realm of the ways that we measure time. We recently had traveled internationally, and we went back and forth over the international dateline, which just confirmed to me that time is something we construct to make sense out of our world. But God could have something else totally in mind. And so when we think of being out of time, it may be standing in God's place, in God's time, people waiting, wondering, and hopeful. And so, people of God, we are each other's kin, and we are family with all of creation. As we wait and yearn for God, we pray together for our community, for the church around the world, and for every need. When I say, "Hurry, God, hear our prayers," your response is, "Tear the heavens and come down." Will you be in prayer with me? Most loving God, you are among us and with us in this very time. No time can take us from your touch and compassion. No time can lift us away from your grace. No time can erase or snatch away the love you give to us. And so we pray. God, the heavens tremble, the stars fall, the earth shakes. We pray for places in conflict. And on this holy occasion, we pray for the people of Bethlehem, where no celebrations are being held due to conflicts with Israel and Palestine. We pray for peace between Ukraine and Russia. We pray for a contagious peace to spread rapidly around the world and to infect all places, for peace to come and stay with us. Hurry, God, hear our prayers. Tear the heavens and come down. God, you garden in the wilderness, even when it seems like nothing will grow. We pray for all of creation, especially water justice, for ecological wisdom for businesses, and courage to do what is right instead of what is easy. Hurry, God, hear our prayers.
Tear the heavens and come down.
God, you create accessible paths through rough terrain, and you love the bodies and the minds of your people. We give thanks for the diverse abilities, and we pray for people in need of healing today. Especially, we offer prayers for Ernest, Marty, Todd, Clifton, Steve, Joel, Jackson, Doris, Dot, Marjorie, Alice, Ruby, Lori, Maisie, Pat, and Jim. Into the silence, we give to you those needs of healing that we give to you now. We give praise and thanksgiving for the 100th birthday of our wonderful member, Opal. Oh, hurry, God, hear our prayers.
Hear the heavens and come down.
God, you call us to rebuild ancient ruins, but we need your help to finish the work. Our need for healing is urgent. We pray for your justice and peace, especially the work of Justice Together here in Wichita, to address the needs of mental illness and homelessness of your beloved children. Hurry, God, hear our prayers.
Tear the heavens and come down.
God, you show us how to perceive each other with eyes of the heart. We pray for understanding in a divisive time. We pray especially for people to join together at tables with no agenda of politics, with ears and hearts to be listening for a hope of reconciliation, even when opinions are firmly held, for a time with conversations to celebrate without berating, the prayer of knowing that our words hold power and pain for those we love the most. Hurry, God, hear our prayers.
Tear the heavens and come down.
God, nothing is impossible with you, but it is hard for us to trust what we can't observe ourselves. We pray for your presence with us whenever we are uncertain or sure. And especially we ask for hope for a day when all will know their worth and life is precious, when people have what they need to live with safety and security, when we can see you in the eyes of each person we meet. Hurry, God, hear our prayers.
Tear the heavens and come down.
God, you are always with us. We gather these prayers together, and we entrust them to your endless love. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Still, one can hear thy
You know, this season is one of unexpectedness. Some are good surprises and some are things that come our way that we can't just wish away. They become part of our reality. And so I share with you these words from Howard Thurman. He's a pastor and a theologian and author, and he's been gone for a few decades now, but he writes in a profound way that touches my heart. And he wrote these words: "I will light candles this Christmas, candles of joy despite all the sadness, candles of hope where despair keeps watch, candles of courage where fear is ever present, candles of peace for tempest-tossed days, candles of grace to ease heavy burdens, candles of love to inspire all my living, candles that will burn all the year long." And so I want you to think about that, that when we light the candle tonight, it's not just for tonight. It is a candle for all the year long. Let us join together now in singing hymn number 217, "Away in a Manger." The words are on the screen.
Verses 1 through 20. "In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be registered. This was the first registration that was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was a descendant from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place in the guest room. Now in that same region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of a great joy to all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about the child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. And Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, just as it has been told them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
There's just no time, right? No time. Or this time is different. This time wasn't what we expected. Not everybody's here that we would want to be here. And with that comes some sorrow and some grief. And maybe some people aren't here because of anger, because they're disconnected. Maybe they had other obligations. All of those are part of the lives that we lead. And yet we stand in this place of being thankful for community, for Emmanuel coming among us once more. You know, joy that is so authentic, it cannot be contained. And I think that's what the angel spoke to that night. And maybe they kind of infected then the shepherds with it when they're like, no, you have to follow the star. Go, go. This is amazing. This is amazing. This is amazing. A community that can help us sort through and live with the things that we can't change. A community that can be present to help us in times of loss and sorrow, as well as great, great joy. I know I'm not the only one, but again, this week, I had that thing happen in life where there was an unexpected death of a friend, and on Friday, in the midst of all of this, we slowed down and celebrated Ed to the fullest that we could, with hearts that were broken. And yet we do both at the same time, which is just so weird. It feels like there's no time for that kind of business, and yet we find the way to live in those times too. I mentioned earlier that Steve and I had traveled internationally, and we were in New Zealand, and we'd gone into this museum, and the Maori people are the native indigenous people there that have some incredible traditions that are followed. First of all, let me step back and talk about time just to get a bit. So we leave here in almost winter to go there where it's almost summer. Long days again. Remember those days? Yeah. And so that whole thing about how we think of Christmas has to be dark, early, lots of candlelight, and yet other people are going to the beaches, and their days are as long can be. And so it's this realization that maybe all those things that we think we know so well, we might need to broaden our perspective just a little bit. And the Maori people, they have what is called a community house, and it's there for all their people to be in. And you can be welcomed into that space, but you just do not walk into that space. And so they had actually taken one of the community houses and reconstructed it with the permission of the elders of the people into this museum. And there was a time that I was standing outside of it, and there was a sign that said, please take off your shoes as a sign of respect before you go in. And I'd been in other parts of the museum, and I kept hearing kind of Christmas music that I wasn't sure was Christmas music, because I could hear the tune, but I couldn't get the words. And as I get closer, there's a group singing inside the community house. And I step in, I took off my shoes, I step in, and I'm listening, and I don't understand the words, but I know the song. I know what that tune is about in that place that tradition has taught us what it is to be about. Now, everybody back here will get a chuckle out of this. They turned to me and said, oh, would you like to sing? Thank you much. Yes, that's my greatest fear in life. For those of you that don't know, that's not my gift. And I was like, no. But there was something that happened in that moment, which was Christmas for me. It was knowing that I am thousands of miles from home. And yet, Emmanuel, God with us, God with me in this moment. This is the place that we come to think about that once more. We will take communion here where we will hold our hands open in that act of receiving that which was broken for us. We will light candles and we will sing because that has become our tradition, that maybe the tears also flow at the same time. As the ushers prepare to come forward to accept our offerings, our gifts tonight do not stay within the walls of University United Methodist Church. 100% of this is going out into the community. The missions team looked at it and thought, what is the most Christmas-like kind of offering that could be made? So half of the offering will be given to Grace Med, medical center that serves all those in community, whether they have the needs to pay or not, and Humankind Ministries that's looking at some sustainable housing for those that are not housed at this time. As you touch the plate as it goes by, I would ask you to think about what it might be like to live in no time, God's time, the greatness of being able to support and care for those that are around us in this city. As we are collecting the offering, we will be singing hymn number 238, Angels We Have Heard on High. Let us remember and give in the graciousness of God's great gift to each one of us. Amen.
Thank you.
invite you to share with me in the prayer of dedication for these gifts that have been received. Loving God, for the time we have, we say thank you. For the gifts we offer, we say thank you. For the chance to help others, we say thank you. For the people whose lives will be better because of these gifts, we say thank you. For the ways you are changing the world, we say thank you. We pray in the name of Jesus, who appears wherever people need our help. Amen. Thank you. And so now we will come to our time of communion. Some pretty easy kind of instructions here, but there is just a one thing that you need to know. So as you come up and receive communion, there will be two stations here. It is a gluten-free option that you are given, so that's an act of hospitality for anyone that might have that issue. You will be offered a cup, and then as you move down, you will need to remember to pick up your candle for doing Silent Night. Now, because not everyone likes to hold a flame, there are battery-operated ones also on each side. And so we just ask that you wait until the time when we come down and then kind of twist that little bottom part and the magic happens and there you have it. Another, just a side note about the candles, as I come down and offer the candle, I will keep my candle upright and I need you to dip the unlit candle into it, straighten up, turn to your neighbor and have them do the same, where they dip their unlit candle in there. I hope that was everything I needed to talk about. This table is open for all. This table is open because of God's great love for all of us, always calling us back to the table where we gather as friends, as family. We gather as community. We gather to find ways of living together. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and forever, to give thanks to you, God Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life onto the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. And when we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. In the fullness of time, you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. And at his birth, the angels sang, "Glory to you in the highest and peace to your people on earth." And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. As Mary and Joseph went from Galilee to Bethlehem and there found no room, so Jesus went from Galilee to Jerusalem and was despised and rejected. As in the poverty of a stable, Jesus was born. And so by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and spirit. As your word became flesh, born of a woman on that night long ago, so on that night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread, he gave thanks to you, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup, he gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all of the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, God Almighty, now and forever. Amen. And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us say the prayer that Jesus taught to his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
The bread in which we will be receiving is a sharing in the body of Christ. And the cup over which we give thanks is sharing in the blood of Christ. Will those that are assisting with communion come forward at this time to receive?
Oh, the Father's love, because
Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves to others. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, as we move to candle lighting time, did everybody get a candle? Good job. Everybody up here got candles? Anybody need one? Hey, we're good. Now we're going to hit some light switches. Did I get them all? This light is like this meal. It brings something into us that we're never expected to keep to ourselves, but we're to share it out into the world, helping those, listening to those, being community to those that are not feeling that they have a worth or a value. God loves us. God loves them. And this is why we light a candle. All stand, please. And this is that hard moment. Do we go ahead and blow them out? Do we go ahead and turn the lights on and keep the candles? It's a hard choice to make, isn't it? There's something special that happens when we stay in this moment of hope, this moment of joy, this moment of what might be in the days ahead. Whatever they are, I wish you peace. I wish you love. I wish you find your place that you have been seeking and looking, and it all becomes clear. All of it. And so we will turn just the lights on the screen and say these words of sending. And then we will turn all the lights on. Join with me, please. As we leave this place, remember whether we are waiting for a new beginning or just waiting for something to end, God is sustaining us. We will keep alert, trust God, seek peace. And so we go.